It is always a simple matter to drag the people along, whether it is a democracy, or a fascist dictatorship, or a parliament, or a communist dictatorship. Voice or no voice, the people can always be brought to the bidding of the leaders. That is easy. All you have to do is to tell them they are being attacked, and denounce the pacifists for lack of patriotism, and exposing the country to danger. It works the same in any country. Hermann Göring, Marshal of the Third Reich, Hitler's designated successor, and second in command. Today, Glenn Beck, self-professed Rodeo Clown, is doing his part to illustrate Göring's point as the chief conspiracy theorist and cheerleader for extreme right-wing paranoia.
Comrades! Good news from the Western Front! Our glorious revolution is starting to take hold. Oh, the revolution of change.
All you have to do is to tell them they are being attacked.
How many times do we have to find a Marxist, a communist, a socialist, a revolutionary, or what seems amazing to me, a simple anti-capitalist near or around or advising the President of the United States before we as a people ask the question? When the President promises us this,
we are 5 days away from fundamentally transforming the United States of America.
Is he promising to transform us into something unrecognizable to most Americans?
I don't think you have any conception of the danger of the Communist Party.
There are literal communists advising the president. Should we maybe be asking some more questions?
Are you a member of the Communist Party? Or have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
We must remember always that accusation is not proof, and that conviction depends upon evidence and due process of law. The line between investigating and persecuting is a very fine one.
This administration is now beginning to use art as propaganda. It's nothing new to 20th century progressives. It has been around for a very long time. But I want you to understand who these progressives are, and what's happening to our country has been a long time in the coming. Oh, down here is, looks like Karl Marx. Lenin, Mussolini, Rockefeller commissioned this art for the lobby of NBC.
Munchausen syndrome, a term for psychiatric disorders known as fictitious disorders, the telling of very large tales, creating imaginary scenarios, and the telling of outright lies.
I'm trying to show you the things that seem to be hidden, but they're not. You need to see the things that are hidden in plain sight. Progressives, fascists, communists.
First it was the Reds, then the fellow travelers, then the liberals, the unions, the churches, the schools, the newspapers, and now whoever dares to criticize the committee.
I have this crazy theory that we are rooted in principles and values. And that's where that we didn't need to be told how to act on 9/12, the day after 9/11. We just knew what was important. Why we're getting so screwed up now is because we're not rooted in those values and principles.
Unless we understand and work effectively for the principles upon which our American way of life is founded, the structure will crumble and our heritage of freedom will perish.
Our rights and our liberties, they come to us from God, and then we lend them for protection to the government. But if you believe in those ideals, it would make sense, at least to me, that God would give us some sort of an early warning system. You know, that is your gut. I think most Americans are saying, gosh, something doesn't seem right. Don't dismiss that. That is a warning system. It makes sense that you feel a little uneasy. And
Glenn, you've been looking into a crystal ball. What the world's going to look like in about 5 years, and how's it look?
Not good, actually.
The military has started preparing for a revolution. When? In the last 4 months they started preparing?
They've been preparing for a while.
They saw the crystal ball like you did, that this could happen?
Look, I was walking with some of the brightest minds in the military about 8 months ago. And I said, so what are you guys really worried about? One guy who was with the FBI before the World Trade Center was one of the first people to say, this is a global terror network. Mm-hmm. He burst out in tears and he said, Glenn, people don't understand. This is 1860. We are on the verge of 1860.
Let's make the unthinkable thinkable. And tonight we're going to think it out with the help of former CIA agents, some of the best money people around, military analysts, survival experts. We're going to try to show you how to prepare for the worst while everybody else is sitting back and hoping for the best.
It's not safe to hope for the best without preparing for the worst.
How about a foreign policy crisis? Well, I don't know, Mr. President. Can you help the general out on the ground of Afghanistan? Could you maybe pick up the pace on that one just a little bit? Foreign policy crisis, oh yeah.
Left-wing bloggers and some in the media have blamed conservative hosts like me or Bill O'Reilly for just stirring the pot. I'm not stirring the pot.
In mid-January, the government war gamed out a scenario where American cities were subjected to a coordinated two-day attack. Why? Are they saying that an attack is imminent like that? No. They just understand that planning for the unthinkable will allow them to act rationally while everybody else is panicking.
We will not walk in fear one of another. We will not be driven by fear into an age of unreason if we dig deep in our history and our doctrine and remember that we are not descended from fearful men. And whose fault is that? Not really his. He didn't create this situation of fear. He merely exploited it, and rather successfully. Cassius was right. The fault, dear Brutus, is not in our stars, but in ourselves. Good night and good luck.
Fox News, the Alamo for Truth.